Hello students, welcome to Green Valley Digital Classes. Today we are discussing the electric field, which a little bit was discussed in the previous lecture. Now today we will discuss the electric field in vector form, electric field due to a point charge. As you know, in previous lecture we have discussed that the electric field is the space around some charge. It is that space in which if another charge is placed, that charge feels the force of interaction. And I have told you in previous lecture that suppose we have a test charge, we have a source charge Q, and if we place another test charge positive Q naught at point P, which is at a distance of small r from this source charge Q. So the electric field intensity at point P is represented by capital E. This capital E is electric field intensity, or simply electric field. And this electric field is defined as the force per unit test charge when this charge, test charge, is very, very small, tends to zero. In vector form, this electric field intensity can be represented as F over Q naught and limit Q naught tends to zero. So this electric field in the vector form, it gives the direction of the electric field at point P. In previous lecture, we have also said that this F is equivalent to, it is the Coulomb's force or electrostatic force between the source charge and test charge Q naught. So we can write F is equal to K, Q into Q naught by R square. So when we substitute the value of F here, we get electric field intensity is, that is K, Q by R square. And here it is R cap, and you know this R cap is nothing, it is the unit vector of this electric field. This is actually the full form of the electric field in the vector form. In previous lecture we have also discussed it is units and dimensions. Now today we are going to discuss the electric field intensity due to electric dipole. But before discussing the electric field due to dipole, first we have to explain, we have to understand what does the electric dipole mean. So this is the next topic, that is electric dipole. Electric dipole is actually, di means you know two, and pole means polarity. Polarity means opposite polarity, one is positive, another must be negative. So what is electric dipole? Electric dipole is actually a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance. I can write here the definition of electric dipole. Electric dipole is a pair of equal but opposite, a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small, separated by a small distance, separated by a small distance. This small distance is called the dipole length. Separated by a small distance, that distance is nothing, it is called the dipole length. So what is electric dipole? It is a pair of equal but opposite charges. Let me tell you what does equal and opposite charges mean. For example, we have a charged particle, and this charged particle carries positive charge, and we suppose that the magnitude of this charge is Q. If we place another charge here, but this charge I took, it is negative, and we suppose that the magnitude of this negative charge is again Q. So we have seen here in this diagram that the magnitude of these charges are equal. Yani that means if this charge is 1 coulomb, it should also be 1 coulomb. So this is a pair. This is a pair of equal. Equal charge means equal magnitudes, but opposite charges. Opposite charge means this is positive, this is negative. And this pair is separated by a small distance. This distance between these two charges is represented by 2a, or you can represent this by 2r, or 2l, or 2d. So this 2a, it is a small distance between these two equal but opposite charges. Then this distance 2a is nothing, it is called the dipole length or small distance. So this whole combination, a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance or finite distance, this is known as the electric dipole. Now the question is, why we represent the distance between the two charges? Why we represent this dipole length by 2a? Why not by a? Why not by d? Why not by r? Why not by l? Because when we take the dipole length 2a, in next classes or in higher in topics, by taking this length 2a, the calculations becomes easy. Suppose if I took the midpoint of the dipole length that is here, then this distance becomes a, and this is a, and the calculations becomes easy. If we take the dipole length as a, then the half of this dipole length will be a by 2, that is in the fraction, and in calculations it will become some difficult. That is why we take this dipole length as 2a. So this combination, a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance, is known as electric dipole. So why we discuss actually electric dipole in the electrostatics? Because there are so many substances, for example chemicals or any other substance, whether solid, liquid or gas, which has the dipoles inside it. Let me tell you some examples. If I take the water molecule, you know, water molecule has a band structure like this. This is the chemical formula for water is H2O. This is the structure of water. And you know, this line, it is actually the bond, covalent bond between the oxygen and hydrogen. Similarly, this is a single covalent bond between the oxygen and hydrogen. And this is covalent bond, but there are two types of covalent bonds, you know. One is known as polar and another is known as non-polar covalent bond. When we are discussing about this bond between the hydrogen and oxygen, it is polar. Because this oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen. So this pair of the electron has shifted a little bit towards oxygen. And we can take that this oxygen is a negative but small, fractional, partial negative charge. This partial negative charge is represented by minus delta. Same amount of charge has been developed on hydrogen but positive, a fractional positive charge. So in water molecule we have seen that this oxygen is carry negative charge like this. This hydrogen atom carries has acquired the positive charge during the bonding like this, and there is a distance between this negative charge and positive charge, that is bond length here. So we can say that there is an electric dipole. So in water molecule there is one electric dipole on this left side. Now we will discuss this side. Same thing happens here. This negative charge, this oxygen and hydrogen has a covalent bond, and this oxygen is more electronegative, so a partial negative charge developed on the oxygen during the bonding with the hydrogen, and a partial positive charge is developed on the hydrogen. So this negative charge and this positive charge has same amount of charges, but the polarity is different. So this is another electric dipole, and this bond length is nothing, it is the electric dipole length, or simply dipole length. So we have seen that in water molecule there are two electric dipoles. Similarly, when you discuss carbon dioxide molecule is a linear molecule, you know, there are also two electric dipoles. the structure of this carbon dioxide is this. When we take the bonding between the carbon and oxygen, this carbon carries positive charge, small and a fraction, this is negative, so is electric dipole. Similarly on this side. So there are different, there are so many compounds in chemistry where there is electric dipole or there are electric dipoles. Now we are discussing the electric dipole. So electric dipole is a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance, which I represent here by 2a. You can represent it by 2l, 2d or 2r. Then this whole combination is known as electric dipole. So we will discuss now the electric field. Yeah, first of all we will discuss the electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is actually a physical quantity which represents the strength of the electric dipole. Which represents the strength of the electric dipole. For example, we have this electric dipole, which is actually the combination of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance, which is known as the dipole length. And we will tell you that this dipole length is a vector quantity and its direction is taken from the negative charge to positive charge. Let me discuss it further in the preceding lecture. So what is electric dipole moment? I have told you that the electric dipole moment is a physical quantity which gives the strength of the electric dipole. It gives the strength of electric dipole. And this electric dipole moment is represented by P. This electric dipole moment is represented by P. How it can be measured for a dipole? How this electric dipole moment is measured for an electric dipole? It can be measured. It can be measured by the product of either charge and dipole length. So electric dipole moment for an electric dipole can be measured by the product of the either charge. Either charge means the magnitude of the one of the two charges. That means mathematically we can represent electric dipole moment as mathematically electric dipole moment, which I have just told you that it is represented by P, whether small or capital is, it is up to you. It is defined as the product of either charge and the dipole length. As I have told you that the small distance between these two charges, that is represented by 2a, is the dipole length. So the electric dipole moment P is defined as the magnitude of either charge. Magnitude of either charge means either the charge of this or this into dipole length, that is 2a. So this is actually the measurement, or we can say this is the mathematical expression for the electric dipole moment for an electric dipole. So in this relation we have seen that the electric dipole moment depends on the magnitude of the charge. If the charge is more, it means the electric dipole moment is more. So we can say that this electric dipole is actually the strongest or strong electric dipole. This electric dipole moment, which we have represented by P, it is a vector quantity. Electric dipole moment is a vector quantity. As you know, a vector quantity can be represented by magnitude as well as the specific direction. So this electric dipole moment has also magnitude as well as direction. If you want to find the magnitude of this electric dipole moment, first you have to see what is the magnitude of the either charge, substitute here, and substitute the value of the dipole length, suppose 1 centimeter, 1 millimeter, or whatever you will give, you get, then substitute here, make them multiply or product, then you get the electric dipole moment. That is the magnitude of the electric dipole moment of an electric dipole. What about the direction? Suppose this is a positive charge. It is separated by a small distance, same amount of charge but opposite polarity, that is negative charge, separated by a small distance, that is 2a. So this combination or this pair of the equal but opposite charges separated by a finite distance, 2a, is known as electric dipole. Now this distance between positive charge and negative charge, this is represented by 2a. I have told you that this 2a is nothing, it is called the electric dipole length, and this electric dipole length is a vector quantity. Now this electric dipole moment, electric dipole length is a vector quantity, so we should take its direction. The direction of this electric dipole length, or simply dipole length, is taken from negative to positive. So this arrow gives the direction of the electric dipole length. Now we are discussing the electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment P is equal to magnitude of Q into 2A. This is the mathematical expression for the electric dipole moment. I have told you just now that this electric dipole moment is a vector quantity. So we put a small arrow on this P. And here 2A, it is also the vector. You know, the charge is scalar quantity. We cannot put an arrow on the charge. So this is actually the electric dipole moment in the vector form. So from this relation, it is clear that the direction of the electric dipole moment is same as that of dipole length. The direction of the dipole length is from negative to positive. So the direction of the electric dipole moment, that is P, it is again from negative charge to positive charge. And when you see the arrow like this, and there is written that this is the electric dipole moment, you must know that this this tail of the arrow, this tail of the arrowheaded line represents the negative charge, and this represents the positive charge. So this arrow is actually the direction of the electric dipole moment. Now we will discuss the units and dimensions of this electric dipole moment. जो मैंने अभी आपको बताया कि electric dipole क्या होता है, दो charges होते हैं, separated by a small distance. जिस डिस्टेंस को हम कहते हैं डायपोल लेंगे, जो वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है, जिसकी डायरेक्शन नेगेटिव चार्ज से पॉजिटिव चार्ज है, तो इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मोमेंट क्या देता है, इस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल की स्ट्रेंथ, कि ये कितना स्ट्रांग है. और हमारे पास जब भी हम डिस्कस करेंगे द इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल, वी टेक एक्चुअली द आइडियल इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल. आइडियल इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल, और सिंपली वी कैन से आइडियल डायपोल. Ideal dipole is that dipole in which the magnitude of the charge is very high. For example, we have this electric dipole. Kya maine bataya electric dipole? It is a pair of equal but opposite charges separated by a small distance, which is known as dipole length, which is a vector quantity. Its direction is from negative to positive charge. So this is the electric dipole. What does ideal means? When the magnitude of charge is very high. Any magnitude of charge is up to infinity, but the distance, which is also known as the dipole length, is very small, tends to zero, then this type of electric dipole is known as short dipole or ideal electric dipole. Or jab bhi hum baat karenge electric dipole ka electric field, chahe electric field is dipole ka nikalna hoga on the axial line, on the equatorial line, or on any point, hum us waqt baat karte hain ideal electric dipole ki. To अब हम बात करेंगे जो ये इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट हमने निकाला इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल का. सो व्हाट इज एन व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट? इट इज डिफाइंड एज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द मैग्नेट ऑफ द ईदर चार्ज एंड द डायपोल लेंथ. दिस सो वी विल डिस्कस नाउ द यूनिट्स एंड डायमेंशन ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट इन सीजीएस सिस्टम. फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू से इन द सीजीएस ईएसयू सिस्टम, the unit of the charge, as you know, is stat-coulomb. Stat-coulomb. The unit of dipole length. This 2A is actually length. This mod represents the magnitude. It is actually measured in centimeters. So, therefore, the unit of the electric dipole moment in CGS term is charge ke badle kya likhenge unit stat coulomb aur 2A ke badle kya likhenge centimeter. So stat coulomb centimeter, sometimes we can say stat coulomb is also known as Franklin, Benjamin Franklin ke naam pe hai. So stat coulomb centimeter is the unit of the electric dipole moment in the CGS ASU system. And in SI system, the unit can be written as in SI system. In SI system, as you know, the electric dipole moment is nothing. ये magnitude form में मैंने लिखा, कहीं पे भी arrow मैंने नहीं डाला. तो this is the product of either charge and the dipole length, just like this. In SI system, the charge is measured in coulombs, capital C, and this 2A is nothing. It is the distance. It can be measured in meters. So in SI system, the unit of the electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. In CGS system, it is stat coulomb centimeter. So this is actually, these are the two units of the electric dipole moment. What about the dimensions? Dimensions of electric dipole moment. See, electric dipole moment is actually the product of magnitude of either charge and dipole length. As you know, in previous lectures, I have told you that the dimensions of the charge can be calculated from this. You know, current is defined as the rate of flow of charges. So charge is I into T. I, this is current, it is a fundamental quantity, you know. Its dimension can be represented by A. A stands for the ampere. And T is time, and put them in the square brackets. So in SI system, the dimensions of the charge are A1, T1. So this, the dimension of electric dipole moment will come out. Instead of charge, we put A1, T1. And you know this 2A is length. The dimension of the length is L1. So the complete dimensional formula for the electric dipole moment is M0, because there is no mass. Uske baad hum likhte hain L1. Uske baad T1 aur last pe ampere raised power 1. This is the dimensional formula for the electric dipole moment. Now we will discuss the electric field of this electric dipole moment. Electric field. As you know, the electric field is actually the space around some charge in which, if another charge is placed, that charge feels or experiences the force of interaction. And electric field intensity, which is represented by capital E, is defined as the force per unit charge. And you know that the electric field due to point charge is E is equal to K Q by R square. Now we will discuss the electric field of electric dipole, or simply we can write dipole. Because we know we are discussing the electrostatics. So this dipole is not magnetic dipole, it is an electric dipole. Electric field of electric dipole ka matlab hai कि आपको इस पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव चार्ज की जो कॉम्बिनेशन है, पेयर ऑफ इक्वल एंड अपोजिट चार्जेस, इसका इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड निकालना होगा आपको. यहां पे आपके पास टू केसेस है, यानी इसमें टू केसेस अराइजेस. नंबर ए, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, यू हैव टू डिटरमाइन द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल. मगर कहां पे? इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ डायपोल ऑन एक्शन लाइन. On axial line. First, I will say you what is the axial line. Dekhe, suppose this is electric dipole. This is a negative charge. This is a positive charge. A pair of equal charges but opposite. Magnitude of this negative charge is Q. Magnitude of this negative positive charge is Q. Matlab, if this negative charge is 1 microcoulomb, it must be also 1 microcoulomb. But positive and negative, so this is a pair of equal and opposite charges. This is known as electric dipole. Then the distance between these two charges is represented by 2A, which is known as the electric dipole length, you know. Now we have to find the electric field of this electric dipole. मगर कहां पे निकालना है इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड? इस डायपोल का इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड निकालना होगा एक्शन लाइन। पहले हम बताएंगे व्हाट इज एक्शन लाइन। सी एसिटेट लाइन विच एक्चुअली इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द सेंटर्स ऑफ दीज टू चार्जेस। एसिटेट लाइन विच इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द सेंटर्स ऑफ दीज टू चार्जेस इज नोन एज एक्शन लाइन। So this line which I have represented here by dotted lines या dots, this is the action line of electric dipole. आपको इसी action line पे इस electric dipole का electric field निकालना होगा। तो कहां पे निकालेंगे? सपोज इधर 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 या लेफ्ट साइड में यहां पे किसी भी जगह। मैं यहां पे एक पॉइंट P रखता हूं। यहां पे दिस P इज द पॉइंट ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन। इन्हें मतलब ये है आपको इस पॉइंट पे जो पॉइंट कहां पे लाई करता है ऑन द एक्शन लाइन, इसी पॉइंट पी पे आपको इस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल का इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड निकालना होगा। मगर कैसे देखेंगे? पहले हम इस पॉइंट पे एक स्मॉल चार्ज रखेंगे क्यों नॉट। एज यू नो दिस इज नोन एज टेस्ट चार्ज। बाय डिफॉल्ट इट इज पॉजिटिव। ये हमेशा पॉजिटिव लेना होगा क्योंकि एक्चुअली ये साइंस ने लिया है। अब देखिए, अब ये पॉइंट पी जो है ये आपको देखना होगा कि इस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल से कितना दूर है ये। लेकिन देयर आर टू डिस्टेंसेस ऑफ दिस पॉइंट पी। यहां से पॉजिटिव चार्ज से यहां तक ये डिस्टेंस है, नेगेटिव चार्ज से लेकर इस पॉइंट तक ये डिस्टेंस है। तो हम कौन सी डिस्टेंस और कैसे रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे? फर्स्ट वी विल टेक द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ दिस डायपोल। देखिए ये डायपोल लेंथ है और यहां से यहां तक कितना है 2a। मैंने इस 2a का मिड पॉइंट लिया। इसका मतलब है कि इस चार्ज से लेकर यहां तक स्मॉल a होगा। इसको दो हिस्से कर लीजिए। इस मिड पॉइंट से लेकर यहां तक स्मॉल a होगा। दैट इज व्हाई आई टोल्ड यू जस्ट नाउ हम क्यों 2a इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल लेंथ क्यों लेते हैं 2a से, सो दैट द कैलकुलेशन बिकम्स इजी। देखिए 2a को हमने दो हिस्सों में किया a। अगर हम पहले a लेते तो a/2 और वो फ्रैक्शन बन जाता और कैलकुलेशन थोड़ी सी डिफिकल्ट हो जाती। अब देखिए आपको इस पॉइंट पे, ये पॉइंट कौन सा पॉइंट है जहां पे आपको इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड निकालना होगा इस चार्ज का भी इस चार्ज का भी। पहले हम बात क्या करेंगे, इस मिड पॉइंट से लेकर यहां तक इस पॉइंट तक जो डिस्टेंस है हम इस डिस्टेंस को स्मॉल r से रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे। सो व्हाट इज द स्मॉल r? इट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द डायपोल लेंथ एंड द पॉइंट p। व्हाट इज दिस पॉइंट p? इट इज दैट पॉइंट वेयर वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल। So this small r is the distance. Then what will be the distance between this positive charge and negative charge? See, this is r, this is a. तो यहां से यहां तक कितना होगा? r को minus a कीजिए। तो हम लिख सकते हैं this is r minus a. अब जरा इस पॉइंट p से इस नेगेटिव चार्ज तक देख लीजिए कितनी डिस्टेंस है। ये लाइन में डाल रहा हूं, दिस एक्चुअली डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस। देखिए इस पॉइंट से लेकर मिड पॉइंट तक तो डिस्टेंस r है, यहां से लेकर यहां तक a है। सो दिस डिस्टेंस इज r प्लस a। So we can write this is r plus a. So ये डायग्राम कंप्लीट हो गई। नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एट पॉइंट p। यहां पे दो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होंगे। एक इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा पॉजिटिव चार्ज का, पहले वो निकालना होगा। दूसरा इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा नेगेटिव चार्ज का। और वो मैं आपको थोड़ा सा याद दिलाता हूं। सपोज यहां पे हमारे पास एक चार्ज है क्यों, पॉजिटिव चार्ज, और यहां पे आपने टेस्ट चार्ज रखा है क्यों नॉट पॉइंट पी पे। डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू इज स्मॉल आर। व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड हियर? यू नो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट पॉइंट पी इज फोर्स पर यूनिट चार्ज। जब फोर्स का वैल्यू देंगे के क्यू क्यू नॉट बाय आर स्क्वायर कूलम्ब्स लॉ, इट कम्स आउट टू बी के क्यू बाय आर स्क्वायर। So this K is constant of proportionality, you know it is Coulomb's constant or electrostatic force constant. This Q is the magnitude of the source charge. This R square is actually the distance between this source charge and point P where we have to determine the intensity of the electric field. So this is the electric field at point P due to this charge. What is the direction of this electric field? As you know, this electric field is vector quantity. We can put here r cap. You know this unit vector. So the direction of the electric field is same as that of force. Force kis pe? Is charge pe. Ye charge positive, ye bhi positive hai. So there is a force of repulsion. Jis direction mein is charge ke upar force hoga, usi direction mein yahan pe electric field. This is the direction of the electric field here. Now see, this is the positive charge, and you know this positive and negative charge is electric dipole. अब पहले क्या करेंगे हम, हम सपोज करेंगे ये नेगेटिव चार्ज नहीं है, देयर इज ओनली वन चार्ज, दिस इज पॉजिटिव. व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दिस पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड दिस पॉइंट पी, आर माइनस ए. सो दिस इज पॉजिटिव, दिस इज पॉजिटिव. सो देयर इज अ फोर्स ऑफ रिपल्शन ऑन दिस चार्ज एंड ड्यू टू दिस फोर्स ऑफ रिपल्शन दिस चार्ज विल मूव टुवर्ड्स राइट. पॉजिटिव पॉजिटिव लाइक चार्ज रिपल्शन. आप जानते हैं कि जिस डायरेक्शन में इस चार्ज के ऊपर फोर्स होगा उसी डायरेक्शन में इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होता है. तो यहां पे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा दैट इज ई. ऐसे दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट पॉइंट पी, दिस पॉइंट पी लाइज ऑन द एक्शन लाइन, दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक टू पॉजिटिव चार्ज. मैं इसको यहां पे ऊपर से पॉजिटिव इसलिए डालता हूं ताकि आपको याद रहे दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड टू पॉजिटिव चार्ज. So the direction of this electric field here is towards right. Now we will see the electric field at point P due to this negative charge. Suppose this charge, we will consider that this charge is not here. So this charge is negative, this charge is positive. So there is a force of attraction. Then this charge will move in this direction. ये चार्ज मूव करेगा इस डायरेक्शन में, बिकॉज दिस इज नेगेटिव, दिस इज पॉजिटिव, सो देयर इज अ फोर्स ऑफ रिपल्शन अट्रैक्शन. आई एम सॉरी, जिस डायरेक्शन में ये चार्ज मूव करेगा उसी डायरेक्शन में यहां पे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा. बट दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, सी द एरो, दिस इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड हियर ड्यू टू दिस नेगेटिव चार्ज, सो आई कैन राइट हियर ई माइनस. So there are two electric fields at point P. One is electric field due to this positive charge and it is towards the right, positive right direction, and another is the electric field due to this, and I have put here it is E minus and towards the left. These two electric fields are actually the vectors, you know, because electric field is a vector quantity. If you want to find the net electric field at point P due to this charge and this charge, that will be the electric field due to dipole on the axial line at point P. But how can we determine the net electric field of these two? You know, this is vector, this is vector. We can add these two electric fields by vector laws. See, the electric field due to point charge, the electric field due to point charge is, you know, electric field due to point charge is K Q by R square. Now when I write the electric field this at point P due to this charge positive, that is E positive, therefore A plus will be K Q, because the charge magnitude of the charge is Q, divided by R minus distance. What is the distance between this and this? That is R minus A. So we can write R minus A whole square. So this is actually the E positive, or we can say this is the electric field here due to this charge. Similarly, the electric field at point P, that is E minus, due to this charge will be the electric field at P due to negative minus Q charge is, क्या होगा, दैट विल बी ई माइनस, दैट इज के, के क्यू बाय आर स्क्वायर. व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस चार्ज, दैट इज क्यू, डिवाइड बाय आर मीन्स डिस्टेंस. व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द नेगेटिव चार्ज एट पॉइंट पी, दैट इज आर प्लस ए. सो वी कैन राइट आर प्लस ए, बट हियर इज स्क्वायर, सो वी पुट अ स्क्वायर हियर. सो दीज आर टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटीज एट पॉइंट पी and due to this electric dipole, then what will be the net electric field? That will be the sum of this E plus and E minus. But we can add these two electric fields with the help of the vector laws, because this electric field is a vector. Suppose in lower class you have studied that if you add two vectors, suppose vector A and vector B, and this theta is the angle between these two vectors, then this is the resultant. This is called the triangular, you know. Then the magnitude of the resultant will be the magnitude of the square of the vector A, the magnitude of the square of the vector B, twice magnitude of A, magnitude of B, cos theta. This is actually the resultant. जब आप दो वेक्टर उसको ट्रायंगल या पैरेललोग्राम से ऐड करते हैं, आज हमारे पास वेक्टर A के बदले E प्लस है, ये देखें A प्लस. आज हमारे पास वेक्टर B के बदले B यहां से नहीं है, बल्कि B यहां से है, तो ये है, दिस इज E माइनस. तो यहां पे देखना होगा व्हाट वाज द एंगल बिटवीन A एंड B, थीटा. यहां पे कितना थीटा है, दैट इज 180. तो देन व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्टेंट, देयरफॉर the resultant electric field, or we can say the net electric field at point P due to electric dipole is net electric field. Kya niklega? That will be E, magnitude of this E, under root of A plus square in the magnitude of E positive square, that is A square plus B square, that is E minus square, plus twice magnitude of E positive, magnitude of E negative, and cos theta, that is cos 180. As you know, cos 180 is nothing, it is actually minus 1. So when we substitute E positive, magnitude of E positive is this, this is the magnitude, and magnitude of E negative is this. Then theta is equal to 180. Substitute the values of this and solve, then you will get the net electric field due to dipole on the axial line. Magnitude of the capital E is simply represented by this. So this is simply E positive square plus E negative square plus twice A positive, A negative, and minus 1, because you know cos 180 is minus 1, that is cos n pi. So substitute these values, we can write here E is equal to, first I will solve this. This is E positive square plus E negative square plus minus minus, 2 ones are 2, that is twice E plus and E minus. So this is a simple formula, A square plus B square minus 2AB. And you know, A minus B whole square, that is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So here, this is A square like this plus B square minus 2AB. So we can write the net electric field is actually A plus minus A minus whole square. Square and root will go. Then we will get the net electric field on the axial line is the difference of the two electric fields. Dekhe. Now you can substitute the value of E plus, that is K cube by R minus A whole square, and substitute the value of E minus, that is K cube by R plus A whole square, and solve it. Dekhe. This E plus is actually the electric field on the axial line due to positive charge, that is K cube by R minus A whole square minus A minus ke badle K Q divided by R plus A whole square. When we solve it further, we get, dekhe, E is equal to, yahan bhi K aur yahan bhi K, yahan bhi K aur yahan bhi Q, ye common aap nikaliye, usse calculation hamari easy ho jayegi. Yahan pe rahega 1 by R minus A whole square, बीच में माइनस के क्यों, तो आपने कॉमन निकाला 1 by डिवाइड में रहेगा R plus A whole square. अब इसको मैं सॉल्व करता हूं. यू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ K इज 1 by 4 पे एप्सिलॉन फॉर द फ्री स्पेस इन ए सिस्टम. K क्यों सॉल्व कीजिए, क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई कीजिए या बाय एलसीएम, मींस दैट इज R plus A whole square 1 जार, दैट इज R plus A whole square, बीच में माइनस R minus A whole square 1 जार, दैट इज R minus A whole square, डिवाइड बाय दिस इनटू दिस, दैट इज R minus A square into R plus A square. देखिए ये. अब हम थोड़ा सा इसको सॉल्व करेंगे. उसके बाद देखेंगे कि क्या एक्सप्रेशन निकल जाएगी. K Q. देखिए, this is A plus B whole square. That is A square plus B square plus 2AB. इसको मैं पहले ब्रैकेट में लिखता हूँ क्योंकि यहाँ माइनस, तो माइनस फिर से ब्रैकेट लिखे. This is A minus B whole square. That is A square plus B square minus 2AB. 2AB के बदले 2RA, because this is A, this is B. Divide में क्या बनेगा, देखिए यहां पे R minus A into R plus A. यहां पे थोड़ा सा मैं आपको सिखाता हूं, ये आपने सीखा है मैथमेटिक्स में, जब प्रोडक्ट होता है तो उनका एक ही स्क्वायर लिख सकते हैं आप. देखिए, you can write here this, this is square on both. तो यहां पे क्या बनेगा, ये a minus b into a plus b, a minus b into a plus b, that is a square minus b square. तो हम क्या लिखेंगे, r square minus a square whole square this. तो ये देखिए, इसको भी मैं लिख सकता हूं r square minus a square whole square. फर्दर सॉल्व करते हैं. So the electric field intensity at point P visualized on the axial line is, देखिए यहां पे जो माइनस है ना, हम इसे इसको ऑपरेट करेंगे, तो ये बनेगा आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर प्लस टू आर ए, प्लस माइनस दैट इज माइनस आर स्क्वायर, माइनस प्लस दैट इज माइनस ए स्क्वायर, माइनस माइनस दैट इज प्लस टू आर ए, डिवाइड बाय आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर एंड होल स्क्वायर. Now see, this r square is plus, this is minus, it will go subtract, this and this will go, these both are positive, so we get a is equal to k q. देखिए 2ra plus 2ra that is 4ra, divide by r square minus a square whole square. This is the expression for the electric field intensity due to electric dipole on the axial line. Now we will proceed further. This capital E is equal to K. देखिए मैं यहां पे इस 4 को निकालता हूं फैक्टर से, क्यों मैंने नहीं लिखा, मैं लिखता हूं 2, 2 के बाद A. अब यहां पे 2 रह गया, दैट इज 2 R, 2 टू आर 4 आर ए, देखिए 4 आर ए. अभी क्यों जो है मैं इसको आगे लिखता हूं, ये सारा प्रोडक्ट है यू नो, डिवाइड बाय आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर. अब कहेंगे सर आपने ये क्यों किया, बिकॉज वी नो, बट वी नो व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट, जो हमने बी से पहले पढ़ा, दैट इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ इधर चार्ज एंड डायपोल लेंथ. सो देखिए दिस क्यू इंटू टू ए, क्यू इंटू टू ए, दिस रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई पी, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट अ पॉइंट विच लाइज ऑन द एक्सल लाइन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल इज फॉर फ्री स्पेस, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के, 1/4πε0, यू नो दिस क्यू इंटू टू ए दैट इज पी इंटू टू आर डिवाइड बाई आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर होल स्क्वायर. दिस विल बी द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन द एक्सल लाइन ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल, बट इट इज इन द मैग्नीट्यूड फॉर्म. नाउ इट इज ओके, इट विल बी शोन इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल ऑन द इक्वेटोरियल लाइन. थैंक यू वेरी मच.